Ondan önce ben hemen sıcak bir haberle başlamak istiyorum. Bugün Moody's, senin de biraz önce bahsettiğin gibi debt to GDP, yani borcun gayri saf milli hasılaya rasyosu küçülse bile biz notunu düşürebiliriz söyledi. Çünkü kongreden bir cevap istiyor, özellikle mali uçurumla alakalı. Onunla birlikte değişmedi aslında çok fazla endeksler, yeşile yakın yataydı. Sebebi de tabii ki Avrupa optimizmi diyorum. Yanımdaki özellikle önemli konuk, iki konuğum var bugün. Yarım saat sonra da özellikle Ground Zero'da Giuliani'nin yanında çalışmış John Odermatt'le buluşacağız. Fakat yanımdaki özellikle Mr. Brian Curry çok önemli. Neden söyleyeceğim, İngilizce konuşuyoruz şimdi. Thank you so much for coming to the studios. Enough with so much Turkish. You are the founder and the CEO of EarthCam.
Correct.
What does EarthCam do?
EarthCam is a leading provider of webcam content technology and services. So we provide many companies all over the world, including companies in Turkish, in Turkey, to provide a monitoring of their projects, construction documentation, all kinds of webcasting over the internet.
But you're very important to the 9/11. You've been there for the last 11 years in terms of the cleanup and the rebirth of the area. Am I right?
Correct. That's correct.
And how did you do that?
Well, EarthCam started out as an entertainment company, so we're based here in New York. And just 2 days earlier, we were doing a very popular event in New York called Broadway on Broadway. So we're webcasting a theatrical event. And when the horrific events of 9/11 took place, we realized that we had technology that we could share with the world. So we had the ability to be able to broadcast the recovery, the rescue efforts. And we went down a couple of days later. I had press passes, so I was able to get down to an area that
So
was.
You were at Ground Zero?
Yes. Yes.
The day or the
A
following
few days
day?
later, a few days later.
How are your memories from that
It
day?
was tragic,
Because it's been 11 years, but the memories are fresh.
Yes, they
What
are.
are your memories from those days?
It was, if had you not turned around and be able to see uptown of Manhattan, you would have thought it was an apocalyptic event. It looked like the end of the world. New York was shattered, it was broken, and it was a difficult event to live through.
And now everybody's down there, and thank you so much for coming here. You're here right now. But why is it important to be a part of this progress in terms of what you're doing in EarthCam?
Well, we realized within days when we put these cameras up, we started getting emails, not just thousands of emails from all over the world, people thanking us for this views, but from the families and the friends of the victims, that we gave them comfort in being able to see that the rescue efforts were taking place. So they were able to have a bird's eye view of the whole situation, whereas they only had snippets on the news. They were able to see 24/7 around the clock, our live broadcast from Ground Zero. And at the time, you know, we put this camera up, it was only about a quarter of a megapixel image. It only updated once a minute. We used very early cellular technology. There was no 4G, not even 3G. It was just the beginning of data over cell phones. So we were able to utilize the latest technology to be able to provide what we did. And we realized right away that we had struck a chord and that it was important for people. And at that point, we had a mission. I had to continue it. And today, 11 years later, we're still documenting and broadcasting live from the World Trade Center.
My producers have live pictures and also videos that you provided me. But what is the growth like? How does it look like over that area at Ground Zero right now?
It's amazing. You know, you'll see a time lapse we put together. I mean, you'll see the dedication and the work from not only from myself, but my amazing staff. We've been, you know, taking images every few minutes for 11 years. And some of the movies that your viewers will see now are 8 or 10 year time lapses that were edited down from millions of images. So you'll see the work and you'll see the effort. And what a lot of people don't realize was, you know, because there was a lot of criticism that it took so long. You know, it's been actually only about 8 years of real construction effort there. First 2 years were recovery and you know, the initial rescue efforts. But what a lot of people don't realize is the first World Trade Center took 20 years.
That's true.
So it's taken less than half the amount of time, and the effort by so many hundreds of thousands of people needs to be recognized, and that's part of our mission. And you'll see in the movie the amount of effort that took place, and it's forever documented.
My last question, we have a minute. Now, I'm going to go back to where we are right now. Things changed in the financial world, in our daily lives, in terms of our security, in terms of the fear, the terrorists, and all the prevention that the city is putting into
is there anything next? How do you feel as an American right now to live here and to be in this, and especially, you know, watching this over the last 11 years? Are you afraid? Are you okay? How do you feel as an American?
I feel much safer today than I did 10 years ago. Saying that, there's a lot we need to be diligent about. We and our technology helps, folks and the efforts for surveillance and, mm-hmm. and counterterrorism. But most importantly, like many businesses change, our business changed too. We went from an entertainment business to a construction documentation business based on what we learned.
Or security too, right?
And security as well, and mm-hmm. Public safety, things like that. So there's been a lot of effort by millions of people all over the world to make it a safer planet, but we need to continue to work and use technology to lead that way, because the secret is there.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And good luck. Well, we as Turkish people, we're used to all these public safety prevention, the earth cams and all these things, because we lived this for so many decades, but United States has been unfortunately exposed to it only for 11 years. And thank you for your efforts. Thank you for coming to our studios.
Thank you.
Cüneyt, burada sohbetimiz sona erdi. Yaklaşık yarım saat sonra John Odermatt'le röportajımız devam edecek. Kendisi dediğim gibi eski komisyonerlerden ve de aynı zamanda Giuliani'nin yanında Ground Zero'da hem rescue hem de recovery effort dediğimiz bu çalışmalarda bizzat bulundu. Kendisi yönetti. Aynı zamanda Citigroup'un Freud Surveillance ve de Global Kriz Management dediğimiz biriminin başında 200 milyon kişinin, 200 milyon müşterinin hesaplarını koruyan birimin başında. Bekleyin, bizi seyredin diyorum ve söz tekrar sana veriyorum.